Wellman from Jindalee Resources. Karen, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Look, news this morning here. Jindalee signed this binding term sheet for the acquisition of 80% of the Deep Well project. Tell us a bit about the asset.
I'm pretty excited to be able to announce that we've signed the binding term sheet today. So Deep Well is located about 35 kilometres southeast of Meekatharra. We've purchased it from a small private company called M61. And they're a bit of a project generator themselves, and they've been pretty innovative in the way that they've identified ground to pick up and the way that they've approached to modern exploration. So they brought this project to our attention a little while ago, and when we saw it, we knew that we had to have it and put it into our portfolio.
And so what's it prospective for, and what do you know from some of the early stage work that's been done?
To give you some background, the project is located on the southern, near Meekatharra, as I said, the southern extension of the Nalwita Greenstone Belt. And the area is barely being touched by drilling, really. There was some historic lines of air core drilling, which were done looking for gold mineralisation probably 20, 30 years ago. But really, there hasn't been a lot of work done on it since then. So M61 went out there and they've done some mapping and sampling, and they've identified a number of outcropping gossans in the region, and they cover a strike length of about 6 kilometres. And what's exciting about these gossans when they sampled them is that they've had geochemical indicators. So that's anomalous values of nickel and copper and platinum and palladium. And these are quite exciting because they indicate that there's potential for massive sulfides in the system there. So, and these gossans have never been followed up with drilling. So that's why we're pretty keen to get in there and have a look for ourselves.
Mm. And so Deep Well, this will form part of the soon-to-be Dynamic Metals portfolio. What's the latest as far as the spin-out?
Yeah, that's right. So with the spin-out, the Dynamic Metals assets, the key assets are our Widgiemooltha project, the one that's located about an hour south of Kalgoorlie, which is got quite good potential for nickel and lithium and gold there, plus our Lake Percy project, which is about 100 kilometres west of that, and that's also got prospectivity for nickel and lithium. And that's why we felt like Deep Well sort of fit into that early stage portfolio as well, up in the Murchison there. So with spin-off, we're progressing the separation here at Jindalee. And right now we're proposing to seek shareholder approval at our upcoming AGM on the 30th of November for disposing of the Australian assets into the new entity. But all of this, of course, is subject to board and regulatory approvals, which we have going on at the moment. So, but yep, it's all happening, and there'll be a lot of news over the next couple of weeks, hopefully.
Good to get an update from you. Karen, thanks very much.
All right, thank you, Andrew.